Do you want to find out what's going on in behind the scenes of your computer and home network? Then stick around to find out how. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is open up a web browser and go to glasswire.com. So you can see I've already got the website up here and I'm actually downloading it at the moment while I talk to you. So you'll see here you can download the free version of GlasWire just here. So you don't need to buy it, but buying it does unlock other features. So you'll also see here PC World Lifehacker have given it some accolades. Basically what it comes down to is that it's a network monitoring, threat monitoring, firewall and antivirus all in one. So you'll see there, whenever a new connection happens, you'll get notified of that down in the bottom right-hand corner with a little pop-up. You can go back and review what happened while you're out, if you've left your computer on. You've got remote server monitoring. That's only available for Windows servers. So if you've got a Linux server, unfortunately, it's not gonna work for you. Internet and bandwidth usage monitoring. So you can see what programs are hogging the bandwidth and pretty much that's it. And you've also got the option of buying it there. So now that we've installed, we haven't installed it. Now that we've downloaded the software, let's install it. So it just comes up with a security warning on the other screen. I'll just pull that across here. It's version 1.2, I accept. That should be fine. We'll hit next and next and next. So it shouldn't take that long to install. And it's done. So what we'll do is we'll run it. So hit finish. And this is what you'll be presented with. Okay, so it's already registered a couple there. So I'm using a program called InSync that works with multiple Google Drive accounts. So that's the first connection that's made there. Again, there's another one. Framework provider, possibly to do with the website. Okay, so let's go and have a look through the features here while it's gathering some information. So this is your rolling information. So you can change it from 5 minutes, 3 hours, 24 hours, week or a month. Okay, you can pause it, you can take a snapshot, or you can do that. You can go and scroll through the different areas and just see what is out there being contacted. Looks like Microsoft malware. So, and then you can unpause it just by right clicking. Okay, so then you've got your firewall tab. Now this will show all the different programs that are trying to access externally, such as CoreSync here. This is to do with the Adobe Creative Suite, Microsoft malware, like we saw before, GlasWire, InSync. So you can block them if you want. So for example, okay, so that might be a paid feature. Oh no, there we go. If you click there. So if you click on the little fire, that will block that particular program. Okay, so let's have a look at usage now. We can see here, so far it's only used 205 kilobits. So kilobytes, sorry. So you can see there the GlasWire is probably used the most so far, but we haven't really been doing anything. So if we leave this for a little bit and come back, you'll start to see the difference in the usage. You've also got apps there, so you can break it down, and traffic. So you can see what traffic is using, whether it's the HTTP protocol or DNS, whichever it's using there. So then we can have a look at network. Now this is one of the paid features, so it will show you through who is connected to your Wi-Fi network. And alerts, these are just the little alerts that will come up in the bottom right-hand corner and tell you when things are accessing things and means that you can check out and see whether or not they should be or they shouldn't be. So you can break it down by apps and you can see there when they're doing their things. And you can see here, so this is the type So Steam, obviously. There's Creative Suite again, Microsoft Malware Protection. So it just breaks it all down. But what I'm going to do is leave this run for a little while and then come back and then see what has changed. Actually, one other thing before I do that is here's the menu, you might as well say. And you can see you can activate it, you can buy it there, you can change the language, changing the skins. Let's have a look at green and pink. So it's not huge changes, but it's still nice if you want to get a different change there. We've got settings, incognito. Incognito, if you, for example, don't want your traffic monitored for a certain period of time, you can go incognito and that will not record it using this program. Okay, so that's pretty much it for that. You exit, obviously. So we'll leave this for a little bit and we'll come back and see where it's at. Okay, so now that we've let that run for a little while, let's go back to it and see what it's found out. Okay, so we have left it for a while and you can see here that it's going through and still recording the data. You can see the apps that have been using the data itself and the traffic where it's been coming through. So let's go to Firewall and we can see here at the moment Google Chrome is using some data and Microsoft Outlook, Google Drive, CoreSync, InSync. And as always, I can block those if I need to by just clicking on the fire. Okay, so then we've got a usage and we'll see I've used 91 megabytes now. Not a huge amount, but still enough to give us a little bit more of an indication of where the traffic is. So you've got Google Chrome there. It's used the most and it's 79.2 megabytes from Google Video. So we can assume that's a YouTube video. You can see hypertext transfer there. Let's bring it out a little bit more. There we go. So you can see HTTPS, IMAPs, that's emails, DNS, NetBIOS, HTTP. So you've got all the traffic types there, all the hosts. So these are the websites or the IPs that have been contacted in order to get the information and the apps that are using them all. So you can see their TeamViewer, GlasWire, Steam again, Microsoft Office, Outlook, InSync, Google Chrome. So you can split it down by apps if you like and the traffic itself. So you can see what's using that other traffic, what's using the HTTPS traffic. It's great. Okay, network. Now I have put in my GlasWire key. So currently it is activated. And you can see here, I'm going to block these IP addresses out purely because I don't want anyone out there getting any ideas. Anyway, so then we can go to alerts and we can see here from date, all the alerts that have come up and what the programs were. So that's pretty much breaking it all down. We'll go back to all, minify that a little bit. There we go. So basically for a program that is, this is a program that is going to help you see what programs are using what data. It'll also help you find if there's, say, a Trojan horse on your machine. If there is, I always recommend using Malwarebytes. But if you wanted to see if maybe it is something like that, then you can always check in the firewall and just see what programs are using what. And if it's something that you're a bit sus on, you can always just block it. And then if it stops something that was working, then you know you can turn that back on. You can turn off the firewall or turn it on if you want. But I recommend leaving it on because it's there to protect you and it doesn't really make your machine run that much slower. So that's pretty much the rundown for the GlasWire software. And I believe that this is a really good all-in-one solution. So after using this software on a couple of machines and using it for about a week, having a look at the ins and outs of it, I really like how it is an all-in-one solution. It works on your network monitoring as well as antivirus and firewall. So it's a pretty good all-in-one solution. The one thing that I would like to add though is that this would be an excellent solution if it had one more feature, and that is specific program bandwidth throttling. So what I mean by this is, say for example, Google Drive is hogging all your uploads, then having a feature in there where you could say limit that one program to upload at a reduced rate, like 50%, 10%, whatever you need to set it at, then that would be fantastic. And that would make this program the best networking tool that I've used. So at the moment, you've got to go out there and buy separate tools to limit the bandwidth for programs. One of them, as an example, is NetLimiter. But that's another expense. And if it could be included in this software, I think that it would be really, really great for a lot of users out there, especially those that are looking to purchase the software. Now, I've provided the links down below so you can download this yourself, and you can also purchase it direct from the GlasWire website. Full disclosure, GlasWire did reach out and contact me and gave me a free license for this software. However, they didn't pay me and they didn't influence my decisions on anything that I made in this video. Well, that's it for another video. I really hope you liked it. If you did, make sure you give me a big thumbs up or maybe even leave me a comment down below. If you do enjoy the content that I'm providing here, please make sure you subscribe to my channel because it really helps me a lot. And as always, imagine, learn, create. Bye.